Undersecretary of State for Resources and Management. Her name is Heather Higginbotham, who we also spoke to and about some of the areas that Namibia and the U.S. have cooperated in. And she also spoke about some of the potential areas that these two countries can explore going forward. Of course, again, indicating that for them, as the United States, they view the peace and stability that Namibia has witnessed during this period as something very significant, and they are hoping that the country will be able to entrench the various democratic institutions that it has set up and ensure that democracy, peace, and stability are things that are maintained going forward. This is a discussion we had with her. In 25 years of independence, how does the United States of America view this landmark or milestone as far as the Namibia's independence and freedom is concerned?
Well, thank you. It's wonderful to be here, and we just had a terrific reception here at the airport. We're thrilled to be a part of the celebration and to attend on behalf of the government and the president. It's an important mark, as you say, 25 years and a really exciting transition. And so we're thrilled to be here. And I'm accompanied by several members, our ambassador. We have a congresswoman from the state of California who's a leader on issues related to the continent and at home, and as well as the ambassador who leads our PEPFAR program, HIV/AIDS.
You just made reference to that PEPFAR program, which has been key as far as the Namibian health sector is concerned. What does the U.S. look at that and the assistance that it has offered through that program?
It's been a really, really successful program from our perspective, and an important partnership, and one that we want to continue. As I'm sure you know, Namibia is one of the countries we've begun a country health partnership with, just one of three countries, in which we're working very closely with the government to figure out which services the government can take over, how we can build capacity and further grow our support. So it's a really important partnership, and it's one of the reasons why Ambassador Birx is here. And she's visited this country many, many times and is thrilled to be a part of this delegation.
And the Millennium Challenge account is another one where the United States has also assisted Namibia. That program has come to an end. But when you hear from the impact that it has had, how does that make the United States feel about the contribution it has made?
It's a really, really successful program. The compact, as I'm sure you know, is under budget, on time. It's a model for the compacts that we are pursuing around the world. It was really successful. We are sad in some respects that now Namibia, the income level has risen to a threshold that makes it difficult for us to go forward with a second compact because the first one was so successful. But it's one that we hold out as an example of how to do things right. And when we're in our meetings in Washington and talking about different models of success, Namibia is one we point to with the MCC compact.
Let me follow up on that point that you've just touched on. The classification of Namibia as an upper middle income country is something that the Namibian government is not happy with because it only looks at the GDP per capita. Do you think in the argument that the Namibia government is advancing, there's some merit because of the income inequality that is prevalent in the country?
It's an excellent point. When we look at the actual legislation, the law that the MCC compact guidelines have to follow, that's in there. But certainly we understand that there's a discussion around income disparity and some of the other challenges. And it's a conversation we'll continue both with our partners back in Washington and here as well.
Now, your message to Namibian people as they mark 25 years of independence, what would that be?
Well, we're here to recognize this wonderful accomplishment, and we understand that Namibians take real pride in this, and we want to be here to support and be partners going forward. And we think it's a terrific opportunity to have this delegation here and to meet and talk with so many wonderful leaders.
Thank you very much for agreeing to talk to us. Please enjoy your stay here in Namibia.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
That earlier interview there with Heather Higginbotham, U.S. Deputy Secretary of State for Management and Resources, talking to us about the relations that exist between the U.S. as well as Namibia. She is leading the U.S. delegation to the 25th anniversary celebrations of Namibia. We're still coming to you live from the Hosea.